Hello everyone. Now I will tell you how to solve a transfer function to the given translational system. See here, determine the transfer function x2 of s by f of s of the system. So this is the given system. In the right side, this is the given system. So in the system, the question directly asking about to find x2 of s by f of s, because there are two displacements, x1 and x2. In the previous lecture, there is one displacement only. So there is directly asking to find the transfer function. But here specifically asking about to find x2 of s by f of s, because here x2 of s is the output, f of s is the input. First of all, same, identify the number of masses in the given system. There are two masses in the given system. So now, for step one, take mass M1. So now identify the applied forces and opposing forces. For M1, there is one applied force, F of t. So now I wrote here. Next, opposing force due to mass M1 is Fm1. So next one, B, friction constant is connected. So opposing force due to the friction B is Fb. Next, opposing force due to the spring constant K1 is Fk1, and another K2, another spring is connected to the M1, so that is K2, right? So this is the next step. Now identify the number of opposing forces and applied forces to the M1. Now here displacement is X1, because there are two displacements, so we have to write the displacement also. Now go to the Newton's second law. Apply the Newton's second law that indicates that sum of the applied forces is equal to sum of the opposing forces. So applying forces is F of t, that is equal to opposing forces Fm1 plus Fb plus Fk1 plus Fk2. Four opposing forces are there. Now I will write the force equations of individual element. So first of all, Fm1, opposing force due to mass M1 is equal to M1 d square x1 by dt square. We know that. That is equal to M1. I am applying the Laplace transformation directly here, M1. So x1 is equal to x1 of s. Opposing force, this is the force equation for M1 element. Now we will move to the Fb. Fb is the frictional force. So Fb is equal to b into dx1 by dt, we know that. But b into, for d by dt, Laplace transformation is s for x1, x1 of s. Spring constant K1. So K1 into X1, because K1 and B, these two elements are connected to the reference. So K1 into X1, K1 into X1 of S, this is also we know that. Now here, please focus here. There is a new point. So K2 spring is connected between two masses, M1 and M2. So for mass M1, there is a displacement X1. For mass M2, there is a displacement X2. So directly spring is connected between two displacements. Already in previous lecture we learned this. So if spring is connected between two displacements, then how to write the expression? K2 into X1 of X1 minus X2. So K2 into, so first we are writing the equation for mass M1. So M1 displacement is X1, then minus X2. We have to write the difference between two displacements. But first, which displacement is important? X1 is the important. X1 minus X2 is the final difference. For example, for mass M2, Fk2 is equal to K2 into X2 minus X1 is the equation, because we are writing the equation for a mass M2. So simply you can compare with the nodal analysis. For example, there are two nodes. If we are writing the node 1 equation, then the outgoing current will be present node voltage minus to the opposing voltage, opposite node voltage. Like that, here also we are writing the difference between two displacements. Okay, so when applying the Laplace transformation, then K2 x1 of minus x2 of s is the equation. Apply all the force equations in the second law, then f of s is equal to M1 S square. So completely applying all the force equations in the main equation. Now here I am taking the x1 of s is the common term. So I am taking the common x1 of s, then the remaining constants will be, this is the expression. Next, x2 of s coefficient is only one equation, that is k2 x2 of s. I am considering this is the equation 1. Okay, step 2. So there are two masses. So already mass 1 is completed. So now we will write the equations for mass 2, that is step 2. So I am taking here mass 2 m2. So for m2 there is a single element is connected, that is spring. So now I am writing here the opposing force due to the mass Fm2 and opposing force due to the spring constant k2 Fk2. There is no applied force. So applying forces are 0, that is equal to sum of the opposing forces Fm2 plus Fk2. Right, now for m2 I am writing in the right side Fm2 is equal to m2 d square x2 by dt square. For k2, Fk2 is equal to k2 into, see here, first of all we have to write the x2 minus x1, the difference between two displacements. Okay, I am substituting these four equations in the main equation, then apply Laplace transformation to the above equation, then 0 is equal to m2 for d square by dt square s square x2 x2 fs. For x2 x2 of s, k2 x2 of s minus k2 x1 of s. Okay, now I am finding the x1 of s, because to substitute this x1 of s into the first equation, then finally I will find the transfer function between x2 by f of s. Okay, so x1 of s is equal to, this is the expression in terms of x2 of s, this is I am considering equation 2. Finally, I am taking the two equations, equation 1 and equation 2. So what is the question? Find the x2 of s by f of s. Now I have to eliminate the x1 of s. So in the place of, in the first equation, I am replacing the x1 of s with the x2 of s by substituting the expression from equation 2. So see here, just substitute equation 2 in equation 1. Then in the place of x1 of s, I have to write the all the expression. Right, then this is the resultant equation. Now see here, now I am taking the common x2 of s, then the resultant equation is like this. So take LCM, k2 into k2, k2 square. So don't forget to take the LCM. Now finally I need x2 of s by f of s. So the inverse of the this expression will be transfer function. Transfer function is equal to x2 of s by f of s is equal to k2 divided by total expression. So this is the answer for the given question. Okay, this is the procedure to find the transfer function of the translational system, given translational system. So I will tell you one more example in the next lecture. After that we will move to the rotational systems, that is also a mechanical system. Thank you guys, thanks for watching this video. If you have any doubt, please comment in the comment box.